everybody.
See if it's zoomed in enough. Try and get on the eye itself.
I've gone slightly overlapped the edge and gone onto the eye, so I'm going to try to gesso over that. I knew this was going to be difficult. That's why I kind of left it to the last thing to do, and just knew it would most likely have a few errors that I'll have to correct. It's not covering that blue up properly. Yeah, because our ravens have white eyes. I'll be doing the what's it called? Iris, is that right? I'm not sure. They've got very slightly oval shaped eyes rather than complete circles, which I tried doing like complete circle eyes and they did look funny, funnier than these do. Of course, typically, because I can't match the same sides, this one is smaller than this side. And this side is slightly more forward than that side, but unless you look at it front on, it won't matter. He looks funny at front on even with his beak too, because his beak's a bit lopsided. But, oh well, don't be too fussy. Where's the fan? Try and dry this again. Going to be going back and forth from this. Alright, so now it's white paint. I might have a bit too much on the brush. I don't want to go over the edge. Although I suppose it won't matter, I can just touch it up with the blue again on the edges. You can still see that blue underneath. Very faint. This eye's ended up being really wonky shape. Yeah, it's quite a bit bigger than this one. Oh well. Alright, fan again. Alright, so now I'm going to try and do the pupil. And stencil, here it is. It's got lots of little circles and it's got a tiny one. I was thinking I might try and do that, except it won't fit over there properly. That's probably a bit too small. I noticed their eyes are just, their pupils are just slightly off centre. I'm just going to just kind of poke the brush through that. This is going to be a little bit awkward, but that's the only way I do it. I know if I try and paint it by hand, there's no way I can do a circle. So, oops, watch me botch this up. Hang on, I'm just going to make sure, holding it up close to me, I've got it in the place I want it. Oops, moved. Oh, come on. Maybe I should just get a little... I was thinking of maybe getting a little cap and dipping it in and printing a circle on there. But stamping, I mean, I'll try this. No, I don't want blue. What am I doing? See, I'm not even organized. I'm not thinking. Oh God, hopeless. Where's the black gone? Oops, oops. Not blue, black. I've got any black in the lid? Yeah. Not that. I hear a little child out the front. If you can see, I can't see. And if I can't, if I can see, you can't. Oh, I'm going to give this a try. If I stuff it up, I'll just use gesso. Ooh! Oh, that's a little bit. Can you see that? It's not a perfect circle, but I don't know whether I should do a little bit bigger. Oh, it looks funny to me. But I'm going to have to let that dry before I turn around and do the other side, otherwise I'm going to smudge that one. There's a raven again. We'll get there eventually, don't worry. Alright. Oh my goodness, my throat. Have a drink. It's a teeny tiny tiny little circle. That looks funny to me. It's very funny. I don't really know how to do eyes. Try and make it a bit bigger. Slightly. Like a cartoon character. I was thinking to just put a few little patches around the edge of his eye because they have like little dots around their eyes. So I'll try that and see if that looks alright, and if it doesn't, I'll have to redo it. Try not to smudge the other one. I want to bring this down a little bit so that it gives him more of a... Oops, too much. Oh, jeepers. It gives him more of a frowny look, I suppose. I probably went a bit too far there. See, I can never do it the same a second time. Now that's what I wanted on this side. It's just a little bit off the top. Instead, I did that one a bit too much. Looks a bit funny. My hubby's not here, so I can't run to him and say, "What do you think? Should I do this or do that?" Because he's been quite helpful with some aspects of this. I like that side with the line across the top, but I don't like the dots underneath. And on this side, I like the dots underneath, but not the line across the top. Just in case you were wondering. Very, very hard to do when you're not really a good painter to start with anyway. Still learning. Yeah, it looks a little bit more sinister. I think I want to do the tiniest white fleck in his pupil, which I might use a toothpick for rather than a brush because I don't trust that brush. It's to not smudge. Really like a very, very fine point brush, but I don't even know if they make them that fine as much as I would want it. No, don't want blue. You want white. Eventually got some paint on the toothpick. Oh, a pretty bird outside. Had some unusual birds around today. There was one we've never heard before in the backyard, and we were trying to find it to see what it looked like, and we couldn't find it. Such a pretty song. Ah, now I've done too much. What do you think? All right or silly? Look at him front on. Oh, he's funny. All right, I'm going to touch up a few of these little white. That are poking through. Have a go at doing the blue metallic, and if my hubby gets back in the meantime, I can ask him what he thinks about the eyes. I'm kind of thinking I'd like to do something different to them, but I'm a bit scared in case I stuff it up and make it worse. There's lots of little white bits still poking through that I obviously didn't paint properly before. Such pretty birds outside. Sorry, I realise you're off camera because I zoomed right in. Never mind. I don't know if you really need to see this anyway. I'm just doing all the little patches. see much better in the daylight where all the little bits are that I've missed. Couldn't see that last night. I'm running out of daylight, so I better get on with it. And the final part is doing the Perlex. And I thought about painting it on, but now I'm thinking I might just dust it on in some places with a dry brush. I think I like that idea better. I'll just check my brushes. Yeah, I think I'll go with that one. So, I might try it on this side first. I'm a bit nervous about this because I've never used this before in this respect. I just want to get some in the lid. And I don't even know if this is going to look all right, but I'm thinking just to do sort of in the crevices so that the wings show up more, hopefully. Well, you can't really see that. Maybe I didn't put enough on. Oh, it's so pretty. The light shining on it to see it. But yeah, I think it's going okay. I'm sorry that the light might not be strong enough for you to be able to see. I'm going to have a look at it later on during editing. If you aren't seeing it well enough, I might take it outside in the morning and show it, you know, in full sunlight so you can see it properly. Turn it around so the light's shining on it so I can see where I've done and where I haven't. I changed my mind and I'm painting it on now because it was taking too long to do the powder and it was spreading in places I didn't want it. So This is working out all right. I think it actually looks a bit better this way. So I'm just following the lines of the feathers in the darker patches, where if it was a pale coloured bird I would probably be doing black. But since he's a dark bird, I'm doing a paler colour. Oops, have I done here or not? I can't tell. So, now I'll go this way. Now I did that in the powder, but it doesn't show up as much as it does when you paint it, so I guess maybe the concentration is stronger. I changed the brush too because that other one was not working for me. It was too big and I was going over the areas, you know, sort of going outside the edge of the area where I wanted to do. A little bit more control with this brush. Okay, there he is. I'm hoping you can see the blue metallic. If not, I will show you during the day, daylight, and hopefully that will show up better. I'm not sure if I'm going to do any more or just leave it like that. I'll have a think about it, but I like how he's turned out. I think he's pretty cool. I hope you liked it too, enjoyed the journey. It was a long one. All right. Okay, it's the next morning. I wanted to show you him in daylight. I just had a look on the footage of what I did last night, and I could see the blue metallic, but I'm not sure whether you could or not, so I thought I'd show him in the day just in case, so you've got the two to compare. And I also wanted to talk to you about what I've decided to name him. I had a few of you ask me if I'd chosen a name for him, and I told you yes, I had. And that it originates from the Edgar Allan Poe poem, The Raven. So I've had to write down, I'll just get a piece of paper. I've had to write down the information because there's no way I would remember it. And if you just hang on a sec,
I'll come back in a minute. Hang on. Okay, I had to write it down.
Okay, so this is his name. And it's a word that's from the poem. And it means that which chases away sorrow, which I thought was pretty cool. I looked it up and it's actually pronounced Nepente, which I think sounds nice. And I thought, given that ravens are generally looked on as a bad omen or an omen of death, I thought that that is really nice, that he is actually a good omen, that he chases away sorrow. So I'll just tell you a little bit about where it is in the poem and what it means. So it's from the 14th stanza of the poem The Raven. And if you don't know the poem, I'll read it, that stanza, to you and then explain what that means. So it says, this is the narrator speaking, he says, "Then, methought, the air grew denser, perfumed from an unseen censer, swung by seraphim, whose footfalls tinkled on the tusted floor. Wretch, I cried, thy God has lent thee, by these angels he had sent thee, respite, respite and nepente from thy memories of Lenore. Quaff, O quaff, this kind nepente, and forget this lost Lenore." Quoth the raven, "Nevermore." So the meaning of that is that the narrator, in his grief, he imagines the air filling up with perfume from an invisible censer, which is a globe that holds burning incense. He imagines angels, which is the word seraphim. So he imagines angels swinging that censer, and he hears their footsteps on the carpet. Then he yells at himself, calling himself a wretch. He tells himself... Sorry, I'm reading and I can't breathe and read at the same time. he tells himself this imaginary perfume was sent from God to help him forget Lenore, which is his dead wife that he's grieving over. He compares this perfume to nepente, a mythological drink that was supposed to comfort grieving people. He tells himself to quaff, which is drink, this potion and forget Lenore, his dead wife. And the raven cuts him off by saying, "Nevermore." And apparently nepente comes from... Oh, now I didn't write that down. I've forgotten. It apparently is in Greek mythology, and it was a plant they used to diffuse, I think, into a potion or a tea, and they would drink it, and... I suppose it would act like an antidepressant, so it would take away their sorrow and their grief and help them get through the bad times. And, so I thought that was perfect thing to name him, because I want him to be a good thing. To me, ravens are a good thing, not a bad thing. And so he's going to watch over me and take away any sorrow or grief that I have. Or help me cope with it. So, and at the very least, just looking at him makes me smile. So, there you go. There's my raven. All done. I can collapse now. It has been such a long, long journey. I'll try and put him in the sun. Hope you can see. I'll turn you around a bit. Yeah, an extremely long task to get him done, and I'm so glad I did it. Yeah, as I've said before, this is my year of courage, and it took a lot of courage to give this a go
and do it on camera in front of all of you
and share that journey with you.
So I'm a little bit proud of myself, actually, that I succeeded. So there you go. Here's my raven. Thanks to everyone for watching, and especially to those of you who stayed with me through every video all the way to the end. Thank you so very much. I really appreciate that, because I honestly thought most people would think, that's a bit too long, not watching that. So yeah, I'm really, really grateful that those of you that stuck with me enjoyed it, and traveled the journey with me. Okay, that's all for now then. I've now got a nice clean desk, and I'm going to start a new project. Yay! Something different. All right, I'll see you again soon when all of that's done and ready to upload. Bye now. Thanks again so much for watching.